share these findings. Initiate soul extraction. Yes! Yes! Just so!
Yes! Yes! Such ferocity! Such tenacity! I am loath to recall how disappointed I was when first we fought. But finally... finally! After bathing in the blood and offal of your enemies, finally you prove yourself worthy prey for the hunt. It fills you even now, doesn't it? The hunger to bite down on my jugular, to feel the warmth fill your mouth and run over even as you drink deep. Good. Good. This is the beast I have longed to face. As you sharpen your claws, I too sought newfound strength. But this is no place for a final contest. Come! The heavens shall bear witness to our dance. Welcome to the Royal Menagerie. The King of Ruin built this place for his foreign queen. He kept it filled with familiar creatures from her homeland. They bored me all. This fine specimen, on the other hand, is simply divine. Your fates are entwined. blessed, are they not, Icon Slayer? This dragon, this embodiment of unbridled despair, born of a desperate man's burning hatred for the Empire. How raw the raging tempest that churns within its breast. No myth made manifest this, but a being of pure violence. Mayhap you are the true architect of our design. You, who fought the very soul of vengeance to the edge and watched him fall. You, who let slip the Elegon Hound to drive this icon into my arms. Oh my, have I said too much? Forgive me, this sensation is wholly unfamiliar to me. A question, then, and I should like very much for you to speak from the heart. If I were to stand aside, what would you do to this icon? You will not indulge me even with a simple reply, then? No. You think only of the fight to come. How alike we are. A pity. There is another alternative. Or there would be. Had you only mastered your ability. I speak of the Echo, of course. Does it merely render you immune to iconic influence, or is it rather that your influence is far greater than theirs? Granted, these implications are of no moment to a savage who thinks only of killing the beast before him. But when I read Van Belsar's reports, I immediately saw the boundless potential. I saw how it could be instrumental in binding an icon to one's will. Hence my research and the resonant. And oh, so much more. All icons must be exterminated without exception. Such was the imperial mandate issued by my great-grandfather after he saw firsthand the destruction wrought by one such being. They are a blight upon this star, he felt. And so he began his great and just crusade. Ha! 'Twas not justice which spurred his campaign, but fear! Fear of the icons! Fear of their power! Cowardice made them march forth to battle. Pathetic. Man should fight for the joy of it. To live, to eat, to breed. Lesser beasts snap and howl at one another for this. Only man has the wisdom and the clarity to embrace violence for its own sake. For we who are born into this merciless, meaningless world, have but one candle of life to burn. I know you understand. You and I are one and the same. Together, we could while away the quiet hours as friend and confidant. If we accept it. And yet, in doing so, you prove me right. We are warriors. 'Twas plain from the first how this would end. You live for these moments, when all hangs in the balance, when the difference between life and death is
is but a single stroke.
I live for them too! This is who we are, my friend! This is all we are! Alamigo and Doma and Garlemald be damned! The gods shall be made to kneel.